Hey everyone, welcome to our channel anujindal.in. My name is Chetan and in today's session I am going to discuss the syllabus of SEBI grade examination. SEBI grade examination mein kya padhna hai, what are the topics, and within those topics what are the subtopics which you need to cover if you are preparing for SEBI grade examination for the next year. Okay, so that will be the entire scheme of things in today's session. So let us start with the session. Yes, so this is our live classes schedule. So I think most of you must be aware that we have launched live classes, live sessions for all the examinations, be it RBI grade B, SEBI grade A or NABARD grade exam. So sabhi ke liye live classes start kar di hai, and this is the schedule of the different subjects which come under these different regulatory body examinations, and this is our application. You may download this application from Google Play, a very beneficial application for all the aspirants out there. So we'll discuss the syllabus of all the six subjects of paper 2. Okay, starting with commerce and accountancy, then management, finance, costing, companies act and economics. Right, we'll start with commerce and accountancy. So this is the syllabus of commerce and accountancy as given in the notification, last year notification. See, the syllabus, this was the syllabus in 2020 and 2022 also, and it is expected that this syllabus will remain the same. Okay, so what is the syllabus? So I will be telling you the syllabus and what all topics need to be covered under different topics of commerce and accountancy, starting with accounting as a financial information system. This is a very basic stuff which basically means that how accounting acts as an information system, what all information it provides. Okay, so this is very basic stuff. It can be easily found on the internet also, or it is also available in your textbooks of 11th and 12th, right? Then accounting standards with specific reference to accounting for depreciation, inventories, revenue recognition, fixed assets, foreign exchange, investments. Okay, before that, basics of accounting is not mentioned as such in the syllabus, but basics cover karne padte hai, especially if you are from non-commerce background. So basics jo hote hai accounting ke, wo cover karne padte hai, be it the debit and credit rules, be it how to pass journal entries, preparation of ledger. Okay, jo basic cheeze hoti hai wo padhni zaruri hai. Then this next topic is accounting standards. So there are old AS and there are new accounting standards which are called Indian accounting standards. So personally, basically this Indian AS is more important from examination point of view, but obviously you should also cover the old accounting standards and try to see the differences and similarities between the two. So only specific accounting standards have to be covered. For example, accounting for depreciation. Now there is no separate standard for depreciation. It is a part of fixed assets. Ye fixed assets ka part hi hai. Fixed assets means PPE, property, plant and equipment. So depreciation is covered under fixed assets. Then inventories, you have Indian AS2, or agar purane standard ki baat kare, so AS2. Then for revenue recognition, Indian AS115. For fixed assets, it is PPE. ठीक है, then foreign exchange transactions you have one accounting standard, Indian AS 21, and for investment property, Indian AS 40. So these accounting standards have to be covered. After that, other topics are cash flow statement. Now in cash flow statement, what all is there? Basically some important definitions like what is cash equivalent. Then there are three important activities which come under cash flow, that is operating, investing and financing. You should know the difference between these. They are examples. Okay, you should be able to classify whether a particular activity, it will come under operating, investing or financing. Then fund flow statement, although this is not very popular these days, and also the data or the information also is not readily available about fund flow. तो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, बट एटलीस्ट बेसिक्स हमको पता होना चाहिए. व्हाट आर द सोर्सेज ऑफ फंड्स, फंड्स आते कहाँ से हैं, फंड्स जाते कहाँ पे हैं, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वर्किंग कैपिटल, उतना बेसिक कवर कर लेंगे तो बहुत रहेगा. देन फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट एनालिसिस एंड रेशियो एनालिसिस. सो देयर आर डिफरेंट टूल्स टू एनालाइज योर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स. व्हाट आर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स? बैलेंस शीट, प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस, कैश फ्लो एक्सेट्रा. सो इनको एनालाइज करने के लिए देयर आर वेरियस टूल्स लाइक कंपैरेटिव statement, common size statement, trend analysis, ratio analysis, okay. So these are the tools of analysis. Then accounting for share capital transactions. So for share capital, you have transactions like issue of share capital, okay. You may have transactions like if you are issuing preference shares, then you would have to redeem preference shares, okay. Then you forfeit shares. Agar aapko shares pe paisa nahi milta, if the shareholder does not pay call money, for example, you will forfeit the shares. So journal entries for that, okay. Accounting treatment for forfeiture, and after forfeiture, you may also reissue. So wo sari jo transactions hain, accounting for all those transactions, including bonus shares and right shares. These are also in the syllabus, right? So you may also expect some numerical questions also from these. There are some formulas you can learn. Then employee stock option plan, what is the accounting for ESOP, okay. And then buyback of securities, the meaning, the journal entries, okay. Then after that, preparation and presentation of company's final accounts. See, final accounts of a company are different from final accounts of a sole proprietorship or of a partnership firm, okay. So company accounts ke there are specified formats jiske according hi फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स बनानी पड़ती हैं, ओके. अगेन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट, बैलेंस शीट, ओके. सो प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट इज नाउ कॉल्ड स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. देन यू हैव कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट, यू हैव स्टेटमेंट ऑफ चेंजेस इन इक्विटी. सो ऑल दोस टॉपिक्स विल कम अंडर कॉमर्स एंड अकाउंटेंसी. सो दिस वॉज ऑल रिगार्डिंग कॉमर्स एंड अकाउंटेंसी. नाउ विल हैव अ लुक एट द मैनेजमेंट. सी, एक्सप्लेनिंग द सिलेबस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज many of you would be from commerce background and some of you would be from also non-commerce background. So you would have to differentiate your preparation strategy, okay. Kis tarike se prepare karna hai, because a commerce student might have studied some of the concepts earlier also, okay. So if I talk about management, so in management, what all topics we have to cover in the syllabus? First of all, what is the nature of management, the scope, okay. Then the management process. So the management process basically comprises of these five important functions: planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So basics of all these, okay. Baki these functions will also be covered in detail. Like directing function basically comprises of your motivation, okay, leadership. These two are the main topics. These are covered separately. Then control, but other functions like planning, organization, it is organizing, planning, organizing, okay, planning, organizing, staffing and controlling, ये चारों functions भी आपको अच्छे से cover करने पड़ेंगे, okay? Different types of plans क्या होते हैं. If I talk about controlling function, okay? So there are certain steps in controlling function, different types of controls. So all those topics have to be covered thoroughly. क्योंकि detail में नहीं explain किया है, so you cannot leave anything. You have to cover everything, okay? Then the role of a manager in an organization, ठीक है? Then leadership, the tasks of a leader. So what is the role of a manager? There are different types of roles of a manager, okay. Then leadership, so leadership काफी vast topic है, तो उसमें आपको leadership की theories भी पढ़नी है. What are the different tasks of a leader, right? Various leadership styles, leadership theories, okay. What is the difference between a successful leader and an effective leader, ठीक है. तो जो भी हमारे subjects हैं SEBI में in paper 2, so what are the source? अगर आप self preparation कर रहे हो तो आप कहां से पढ़ सकते हो, okay. For that I have already made a video on book list for SEBI grade exam paper 2. So you can watch that video of SEBI book list on our channel अगर आपने वो नहीं देखी है, right. Then human resource development, what is the concept, what is the meaning of the concept of human resource development. Then a concept of HRD, okay, and goals of HRD, very very important, ठीक है. तो HRD also, human resource management भी आपको cover करना पड़ेगा, directly mentioned नहीं है, but human resource management is connected with your staffing function. तो ये सारी चीजें आपको cover करनी है. Apart from that, in management, you would also have to cover motivation, morale, and more importantly, difference between motivation and morale. Then incentives, types of incentives, role of incentives, right? Then theories of motivation. So theories of leadership and theories of motivation, very very important. Then how managers motivate. Then concept of morale, factors determining morale, okay. And role of incentives in building up morale. Then after that, the last topic in management is communication, and communication itself is a vast topic. Like what you have to study under communication, the steps in the communication process, okay, communication channels, different channels, then oral versus written communication, verbal versus non-verbal. Now in non-verbal, there are different like gestures. Gestures come under non-verbal communication. Then upward, downward and lateral communication, barriers. there are different barriers to communication which act as a hindrance, right? Then role of IT in the communication process, because increasingly we are using IT in our communication. So this was regarding management, the detailed description of the syllabus of management. After that, the next subject is finance. Okay, so finance mein kya kya padhna hai aapko? Okay, so in finance, we'll start with financial system. So, okay, what is the meaning of financial system? Then you have to study about Indian financial system. Then the components of a financial system, like in a financial system, there can be financial institutions, financial instruments, financial market, etc., financial regulators. Okay, and so role and functions of regulatory bodies in the financial sector, that you have to study thoroughly. Then financial markets. Now, financial markets, they can be of different type, like primary and secondary market. And under secondary market, you can make further classification like forex market, money market, bond market, equity market, right? Then functions, instruments, recent developments, okay? So these all, so markets, see, there are more markets also, like commodity market is also there, okay? Derivative market is also there. So all the different types of financial markets you need to cover. Then there are some other topics also which can be covered, like basics of derivatives. Now basics of derivatives, it's a little tricky for someone who is from a non-finance or non-commerce background, but you may understand it. Aisi koi problem nahi hai. Matlab, you may have to put some extra effort obviously, but you will understand it. Okay, so basics of derivatives, there are different types of derivative contracts like forward, future, swap. So guys, jo bhi syllabus mein given hai, sab kuch karke jana hai. You cannot leave anything. Be very very sure about this. You have to cover this entire syllabus, जो भी मैं बता रहा हूँ, okay? और थोड़ा extra ही पढ़ेंगे तो better रहेगा, because some of the topics जो हैं, उनकी बहुत ही detailed description नहीं दिया है कि आपको कितना पढ़ना है. तो in that case आपको you have to cover the entire topic, obviously. Then recent developments in the financial sector, whatever recent developments, be it in the fintech sector or maybe in some other new technology coming up in the financial sector, that you have to cover. So this also gets covered up through finance current affairs. You may be following some finance current affairs maybe on our channel. Okay, then financial inclusion, very very important. Okay, a lot of government schemes regularly are aimed at financial inclusion, so you have to understand the concept of financial inclusion. It is a very vast topic. Okay, demand side factors, supply side factors, and various other things are there under this. Use of technology, how technology is helping in making our society more financially inclusive. Then alternate sources of finance. Okay, so like traditionally we used to take bank loan or maybe some other type of loan, equity. Those were our traditional sources of finance, but now many new sources of finances have come, like peer-to-peer lending or crowdfunding, etc., etc. Then private and social cost benefit, okay, very very important. Then public private partnership, PPP projects, like the highways and the roads which are being built by the government in partnership with the private builder, right? Then direct and indirect taxes, okay, non tax sources of revenue. Then GST, very important, basics of GST at least you should know. Then finance commission, what is finance commission, its role, fiscal policy. Then FRBM Act of 2003 is also very very important from examination point of view. Then concept of inflation, what is inflation, its definition, recent trends, okay, various estimates which are being used by the government, okay, like WPI, CPI. Then consequences, remedies, how to control inflation. So as I told you, WPI, CPI, what are their components and what is the trend under this. So this also you have to study. So this was regarding the subject of finance. Then after that comes your costing or cost accounting, whatever you may call. So as you know, there are three branches of accounting: financial accounting, cost accounting, and management accounting, right? So financial accounting comes under your commerce and accountancy subject. Now this costing will cover your cost accounting and some basics of management accounting, because management accounting bahut detail mein nahi hai syllabus mein, but basics thode se, like overview of cost and management accounting, theek hai? Then what are the objectives, what is the scope, this all basic stuff, theek hai? Then methods of costing, so there are different methods and different techniques of costing that you have to cover, like single output, unit costing, job costing, batch costing. So you should be aware of the differences and the examples of all these different methods: contract, process costing, service sector costing, right? then basics of cost control and analysis, like standard costing. Under standard costing there is also the topic of variance analysis. Explicitly nahi likha hai, but it comes under standard costing. Then marginal costing, you have CVP analysis, very very important. Numericals aa sakte hain, theek hai, this is really important from numericals point of view. Then budget and budgetary control, different types of budgets, okay, all those topics. Then after that in costing you also have to study lean system. Okay, there are different types of lean systems like just in time, kaizen, 5s, TPM, okay, cellular manufacturing, six sigma, then BPR. So all these you have to cover in detail, because koi bhi question yahan se puch sakte hain aapse, right? This was regarding lean system. Then the next subject is Companies Act of 2013. So Companies Act mein aapko pura nahi padhna hai, so that is a big relief. But you have to study these basic chapter, these specific chapters jo syllabus mein mentioned hai, theek hai. What are those chapters? Chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 8, 10, 11, 12, 27, and these are the sections under these chapters. So you have to be aware of the recent amendments also, bahut important hai, because अमेंडमेंट्स आती रहती हैं किसी भी एक्ट में. तो जो भी चेंजेस हुए हैं, चाहे वो पेनल्टीज में चेंज हुआ हो, जो भी चेंज हुआ हो, तो यू हैव टू स्टडी द लेटेस्ट वर्जन ऑफ द कंपनीज एक्ट. तो एमसीए की वेबसाइट पे ई बुक मिल जाती है, वैसे वो अपडेटेड होती है ई बुक ऑन द एमसीए वेबसाइट, बट नहीं मिलती है तो आपको यू हैव टू रेफर टू द लेटेस्ट मटेरियल फॉर कंपनीज एक्ट, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, ठीक है. सो दीज आर द स्पेसिफिक चैप्टर्स. So you should be aware of all the terms which are being used in these chapters and all the related provisions also, okay, penalties, provisions. Then last subject to cover is economics, okay, last in the sense, last in the notification. So in economics it is a mixture of Indian economy, macroeconomics and micro, sab kuch hi hai isme, okay. So it starts with demand and supply, okay, what is the concept of demand, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सप्लाई, इलास्टिसिटी, ये भी इसमें आ जाएगा, ओके. डिटर्मिनेंट्स ऑफ डिमांड, फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग डिमांड, फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग सप्लाई, ओके. मार्केट डिमांड वर्सेस इंडिविजुअल डिमांड, ऑल दोज कॉन्सेप्ट्स. देन मार्केट स्ट्रक्चर्स लाइक मोनोपोली, ओलिगोपोली, ओके. यू हैव फेयर परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिशन, ऑल दोज. देन नेशनल इनकम, वॉट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नेशनल इनकम एंड वॉट आर द डिफरेंट मेथड्स एंड वेज टू कैलकुलेट नेशनल इनकम, ओके. सो नेशनल इनकम से कनेक्टेड जो भी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट हैं वो भी पढ़ने पड़ेंगे आपको, ओके. सिमिलरली डिमांड और सप्लाई से जो भी रिलेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट होते हैं वो आपको पढ़ने चाहिए, ओके. बिकॉज कुछ टॉपिक्स ऐसे हैं, मतलब सब्जेक्ट, काफी सारे सब्जेक्ट्स में जो एक्सप्लिसिटली मैंशन नहीं है, बट कंसेप्चुअली समझना जरूरी है इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड अदर टॉपिक्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम या प्रोड्यूसर इक्विलिब्रियम वाले कॉन्सेप्ट मैंशन नहीं है, ओके. बट इफ यू स्टडी कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम, इफ यू स्टडी प्रोड्यूसर इक्विलिब्रियम और प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन, देन इट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड अदर टॉपिक्स ऑल्सो बेटर, ठीक है. देन देर इज क्लासिकल एंड कीन्जियन अप्रोच to determine output and employment. These are the two major schools of thought, classical school of thought and Keynesian school of thought. Then consumption function, investment function, the concept of multiplier and accelerator, very very important. The various factors of consumption function, factors of investment function, how do we draw a graph of these functions, okay, very very important. Then demand and supply for money, okay, what how demand of money is determined, how supply for money is determined. Then what is the concept of ISLM curve, because demand and supply for money is connected with your ISLM curve. Then inflation, what is the concept of inflation and what is Phillips curve, very very important. Then what is the concept of business cycle, ye bhi cover karna padega, right. So ye kuch topics hai hamare economics ke. And yes, after that balance of payment, BOP statement. So under BOP statement there are different you know segments like current account, capital account, then official reserve statement, तो वो सारा कुछ अच्छे से cover करना है. Then forex market, okay, various there are various concepts in forex market like spot rate, future rate, or there can be you know nominal exchange rate, real exchange rate, तो वो सारे topics अच्छे से cover करने हैं. Then concept of inflation, this is already being discussed under finance also. Then monetary and fiscal policy, the difference between these two policies, the tools which are being used under these policies. And then finally non-banking financial companies or non-banking financial institutions, their types, their role, their functions, etc., etc. So this was regarding economics. सो दिस वॉज द एंटायर सिलेबस आई वॉन्टेड टू डिस्कस विद यू. ओके, बिकॉज सिलेबस अगर हमें समझ में आ जाता है देन हाफ आर जॉब इज डन. ओके, सिलेबस समझना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है बिफोर यू स्टार्ट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एनी एग्जामिनेशन. एंड सिंस द सिलेबस इज अ बिट वास्ट, सो आई फाउंड इट यूजफुल टू मेक अ सेशन ऑन सिलेबस. चलिए, ऑन दैट नोट आई एंड द सेशन हियर. ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट गाइस, टेक केयर, गुड बाय एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.